In this screencast, I'm going to provide just a brief introduction to multi-stage batch distillation. The idea is we have a still that we start out with liquid that we want to separate, in this case a binary mixture. We're going to have a column that's going to improve the separations. The vapor that leaves is then condensed in a condenser, and then much of it is recycled as liquid, and some is collected as the distillate. And for the conditions in this particular column, we're showing that the more volatile component, B, is enriched significantly in the liquid that we start collecting. So this is the distillate, and this is the reflux. On the right, we show the mole fraction of vapor over mole fraction of liquid for this particular binary mixture. So this is basically the blue line is equilibrium data, for example, say from Raoult's law for ideal solution. And the red line is the operating line. So the operating line goes through this red point, which is the mole fraction of the distillate. So this is the distillate, and you can see the still mole fraction here, and this is slightly different conditions. This is starting with a mole fraction of 0.31, a reflux ratio of 4.2, and the reflux ratio is the liquid flow rate over the distillate flow rate. And then the slope of this line is related to this reflux ratio. So batch stills are used typically if we have smaller quantities that we want to separate. They're a lot more flexible. The same system can be used in sequence for different mixtures. It also allows each batch to be identified. You know, what were the exact feed conditions, the conditions where we carried out, how long, etc. And for pharmaceuticals or for food, this could be important. So the typical way that this would be run is we start out where we close this valve and we completely reflux at the start and let the system get to equilibrium. This allows us to get the best separation. Then we open the valve and start collecting. Now, unlike the diagrams you see, say for continuous distillation, the McCabe-Thiele type diagrams, as we distill the liquid, the mole fractions in the still change and the mole fraction of the distillate change, which means these red and the blue points are moving, which means the line is moving, the red line is moving. The blue line is just equilibrium data, so that doesn't change. But the red line is going to move as distillation proceeds, but the slope remains the same, just R over R plus 1. So let's look at what this YX diagram would look like at a later time. So here I'm showing the same Y versus X figure, but now we've evaporated 0.23 moles from the still. So that means the distillate composition has changed significantly and the still composition has changed. So the diagram, the operating line, moved. The slope has not changed. And so this continuous change we take into account when we do the calculations, determine what our distillate composition would be for a given condition. Well, the other aspect we want to look at is what happens to the temperature. So the temperature is going to be higher at the bottom of the still than at the top, but the temperature in all locations also changes with time because the composition change, and the temperature increases because as the batch distillation proceeds, we become enriched in the less volatile component, the component with a higher boiling point. So let's look at a TXY diagram so we get a better idea, and we'll look at that at two conditions. So here we're looking at temperature versus mole fraction. Again, the blue line corresponds to vapor-liquid equilibrium, and the stages are counted off by referring to the YX diagram and the operating line there. The point that's important here is this is a case 5 stages, and the temperature is 86 degrees in the still when we start, but it's only 77 degrees at the top of the column. So 86 degrees, you can see the blue, and then 77, it's a little harder to see this red point here. And then after we've evaporated 30%, notice the stages, the locations have changed. The temperature's down 93 degrees in the still, and then 78 at the top of the column. Look at one more figure where we've evaporated even more. So here, it's the same starting conditions, but now the temperature in the still is 103 degrees, and the temperature at the top is 94 degrees, and this is because we've now evaporated 50% from the still. Well, if we go back and let's look at this YX diagram again, the separation, the composition, the distillate is going to depend on how many stages. I've showed 5 stages. Obviously, more stages, we get better separation. Also, depends on that reflux ratio because it's related to the slope of this red line. If we increase the reflux ratio, we're going to get better separations. Now, of course, if we increase the reflux ratio, then it means the process is slower since we're sending more back into the column and only collecting a smaller amount. Now, these columns can be operated where the reflux ratio is constant. That's essentially what I'm showing here. The slope of the red line doesn't change. Or as distillation proceeds, we could increase this reflux ratio, which would result in increasing our separations, giving us a higher product composition. But this is at the expense of taking more energy and taking a longer time. So in a subsequent screencast, I'll discuss how we do the analysis for a batch reactor, how we use the number of stages to determine our compositions, and how we use them and how they change as a function of time.